There's a part in the Course in Miracles where Jesus says an untrained mind can accomplish nothing. And he also says at one point that you are much too tolerant of mind wandering. So it's great. I always say, give it to me straight, Jesus. If I'm too tolerant of mind wandering, if I've got compromise going on in my life, if I've got people pleasing, if I'm avoiding something, if I'm trying to dance around something, the prayer of the heart is, reveal this to me. Expose this to me. How am I going to escape these ego games unless I get them brought to me, sometimes like right into my nose? Like we were talking about at the break, the prayer, Holy Spirit, bring it on. And I always say, be ready if you actually say those words to the Holy Spirit, because that's a wide open invitation to clear the mind. I even had a retreat I did in Spain on the island of Mallorca, where it was a 6-week retreat, and I think somewhere around week 4, somebody in the group threw their arms in the air and said, bring it on, Holy Spirit, bring it on, and then another one, and then the whole group basically was throwing their hands in the air, and as loud as they could say the words, were belting out, Holy Spirit, bring it on. Well, that group had quite a number of interesting experiences that came on. We had somebody who left in remission from cancer and all kinds of things that happened. It was almost like a revival. And then subsequently, there's been all kinds of reverberations in people's lives after that. But that's a good example about how the more willing we are, the more open we are, the more we can ask for help, the more help can be given us. And there's another part in the Course where Jesus says, it's not that you ask for too much. You always ask for far too little. That it's this unworthiness, this shame, this guilt that we've held on to, this mostly unconscious, that actually brings limits to our life experiences, where we're capable of huge openings, of vast openings. At times, it's like such a fear of love and light. It's almost like holding up a little thimble with a shaky hand and going, could I have a refill, please? And Jesus is like saying, yeah, get a bucket. Get a bucket. You know, we're so accustomed to thinking that we just aren't worth that care and attention. We may have all kinds of old programs running like, oh, God must be really busy. He's not, certainly doesn't care about me, but that's actually the opposite to what things really are. There's all this love and light waiting to pour through our mind, waiting for us to be a conduit, and yet we have to ask for it. We have to really prepare, be prepared and ask for it.